Surgery for single ventricle defects is among the most complex of cardiac procedures performed on the smallest of hearts. The first of three planned operations occurs within the first few days of life.
Children with single ventricle, by definition, only have one pump, and of course we have to use that pump to pump the blood to the body. So the question is, how do we get blood flow to the lungs?
Their circulation mimics normal, but is still not a normal one. The blue blood makes its way to the lung, and the pink blood makes its way to the body, but in a very different way than what one would expect if you had two pumping chambers.
So what we try to do is basically take what we have and make it work. The Fontan circulation is basically taking the blood supply that's returning to the heart as blue blood and putting it into what we call a cavopulmonary connection, which is that blood averts the heart completely and instead the blood flows directly into the pulmonary arteries and into the lungs. It's not an operation we can do all at once. It's a three-stage process that usually starts with the first operation around the time of birth, the second operation around 4 to 6 months of age, and the third operation usually around 2 years of age.
And we now know that that allows for survival and a relatively good quality of life.
It is an amazing place, the cardiac operating room, and it's all about teamwork.
There's nobody that has a finer team, I think, of surgeons than we have here. Their outcomes are remarkable. Their skill set is remarkable, and they're also remarkable individuals.
They're all working with the goal of taking care of this little tiny heart that's on the operating table. And I always find it such a privilege to be able to see the heart moving, to see the surgeons doing such delicate work in a very, very small field.
It's vitally important that you have an anesthesia team that really understands their physiology and can care for them as they undergo multiple procedures.
It's worked best for us to have a small, cohesive team that are very focused on this subspecialty. And there's a lot to learn, there's a lot to master, and it's constantly evolving over time.
Not only do the anesthesiologists bring the usual technical abilities to the table, they also have this unique understanding of cardiac anatomy and physiology.
And that's so important to having successful outcomes with their procedures. And they are a very integral part of our team.